your crush so nice to you sometimes that you feel like you're on cloud nine, and then other times he acts like he couldn't care less? Did you just have an amazing conversation or date, and now he's disappeared or hasn't contacted you since? Did it totally feel like you were moving toward a relationship, and now you're just not sure? Well, ladies, there are a number of different explanations as to why guys give mixed signals. And as a relationship and couples therapist, I'm gonna break down the top 7 reasons why he might be acting this way. Even though mixed signals can be so frustrating, it's so much better to not get angry or have an outburst, because then we're just gonna ruin our chances of a relationship anyway. The best thing to do is sit here and analyze these responses so we can know what can actually get us closer to a relationship. And before I get started, I wanna say that mixed messages can actually be really positive in certain contexts, but they can also be really negative, and I'm gonna dish the dirt on what that means as well. Now, the first explanation is actually really positive and encouraging.
Yes!
And it's that he's not sure. He's actually confused. Maybe he's trying to decide between you and another girl, he's trying to decide if he wants a relationship at all, or he's just feeling you out to see if he actually likes you. You know that period where you're first getting to know someone? Well, he could really be back and forth trying to determine if you're actually a match for him. So your best bet is to give him the time and space to actually figure it out for himself. If you like him, this is actually such an amazing opportunity to show him how awesome you are. Think about it as your chance to win him over, to impress him, to really show him that you're the girl for him. Number two is that he's just happy being friends. In a friendship, people are a lot less likely to have regular, consistent conversation, like a nightly phone call or a nightly text message. So if he texted you once and then never texted you again, this is perfectly logical in his mind if he just wants to be friends. Number three is that he found someone else. When a guy really looks like he's pursuing you and then he just stops, he just goes completely AWOL, there is always the chance that another option presented itself, and that maybe things actually move faster in that arena than it did in your relationship. So that would explain someone just disappearing because they've decided to pursue another relationship instead. Now, if this is the case, I don't think there's any reason to get too upset. It may have felt like a really promising and amazing date or conversation or experience that you had, but ultimately, if he chooses someone else over you, I truly believe that that relationship wasn't meant to be anyway. Ultimately, you wanna be with a guy who appreciates and respects you for who you are and wouldn't choose somebody else over you. So, away with him. Number four is that he could be a commitment phobe, like the kind I described in the 6 guys to avoid video. With this type of guy, it's like he doesn't really want anything serious, but he's willing to have the connections and the perks of being in a relationship, which is why when he gets the opportunity or when he's in like a relationship kind of mood, he'll be extra nice and sweet because he wants to feel those emotions. But when it comes to a relationship, he's not really willing to put the time and the effort in. Number five is probably the best possible option. He likes you, but he's just waiting to see your reaction. So say he takes you on a really romantic, amazing date on the weekend where you both have a great time, but then you get to school or work on Monday and you barely get a hello. The truth is, he may actually think that his job is over and he's waiting for you to now initiate something since he just initiated the date. If he reads any kind of nervousness or hesitation in your face, he may actually think that you don't like him, and that might even encourage him to not pursue any future contact with you either. So it's really important to be displaying really positive signs of body language around him so that he knows that you like him and he feels a lot more comfortable making the move again. So number six is kind of sad. It's that he doesn't actually like you. This can come as a result of reading too much into things. So sometimes when we really, really like someone, it's easy to mistake, you know, a friendly personality or just like friendly chatter for that person actually liking us in a romantic way. So if this is the case for you, absolutely don't worry. You are not doomed. It just might mean that he hasn't seen you in that way yet, or he hasn't considered the possibility of a relationship. Now, number seven is that he's just a playboy. Now, ladies, remember my video, The 6 Guys to Avoid? Well, the playboy was the one that made you feel like $1 million, but he's also making every other girl feel like they're $1 million too. The playboy gives you mixed signals because he's not serious at all. He just loves to flirt. And in my opinion, it's definitely not a good idea to waste your valuable time and resources investing into this guy. Do you need help going from the crush stage to more of a relationship? Well, check out my recent video, 8 Surprising Ways Out of the Friend Zone. You're gonna get so much help here. So if you like this video, give it a huge thumbs up, and don't forget to come and follow me over on Instagram and Twitter for your daily dose of relationship advice. And of course, subscribe to this channel for more weekly videos on relationships. Bye for now.